This is a due process procedure. And so can you show me the documentation that says that the cutoff date for us to view as the public is, was on the election day?
Okay, when I said they view, I was talking about viewing the process, not viewing the ballot.
I asked, could I view the ballot? So you're saying, you're talking about.
No, no, in other words, the starting, because of COVID, we had authority to start processing the ballots 30 days before an election. Governor's executive order gave us that authority.
And so you're saying the governor's executive order took away due process?
No.
Okay.
It changed. We normally have 5 days to start opening up ballots and processing. Because of COVID and because of the relaxing of the rules dealing with absentee ballots for the presidential primary and the primary, and then the vote by mail law, the number of absentee ballots increased for a primary election about tenfold. Mm-hmm. For presidential primary, probably 20-fold.
Okay, that's good news.
Okay. No, I'm just giving you,
yeah.
and because of that, mm-hmm. it would have been absolutely impossible for us to do that, to handle the number of ballots we had to handle in that five days. So they gave us 30 days, okay? And that's done as a public meeting where members of the public can come in and observe the process, not observe the ballots.
Okay, now I got another question for
you. Okay, so, and that's what we're talking about, observing the process. People come in, they can sit, they can watch the folks doing what they're doing.
But not actually see the ballot.
Not actually, you may inadvertently see a ballot just simply because you're sitting there and you'll see something.
Okay, if you have a dispute right now about, you think there's some concerns with the ballots, how do we do that right now with you or with the department?
You can come to the certification on Friday.
Okay, on Friday, but you'll be certified. I have another question for you, though.
Yeah.
You had said to me that there's 44,000 ballots that have been processed. Is that correct? Then you said, and I asked you, I'm not concerned about the whole 44,000. I'm just concerned about Wilmington. Then you said to me.
Let me show you.
Okay, no. Hold on. Okay. I want to ask you the question before you go.
Yeah.
Then you said to me that the Wilmington ballots are all mixed in with the state ballots. Is that not correct?
That's absolutely correct.
Now, why would that happen?
Okay. We receive ballots every day.
Mm-hmm.
To several different sources, but we receive ballots every day.
Mm-hmm.
In order to process them, we'll just talk about mail because it's the same as the other thing. Those by email, those by fax, or those by Dropbox, essentially the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
We get a tray of ballots. We turn that over to a team, they open them up. Those ballots are sorted by, doesn't matter how they're sorted, you have a tray of ballots. Right now they're sorted alphabetically.
Mm-hmm.
We can sort them by election district.
You can?
Yeah, sure.
Why weren't they?
Because it's more efficient to do it alphabetically.
It's not more efficient because if I have a complaint and I need to see Wilmington as a whole, I don't need to go through 40,000 ballots.
But we're still processing them by day. Once they're processed by day, let me go get some.
Okay, while you do that, I'm going to say to Albany's is this. I want Wilmington segmented by itself so that we as the public and we looking at this can see all the Wilmington votes. I'm not concerned about what happened statewide.
I know you're not.
Okay, all right. You go get what you're going to get.
I But what about the machine?
Y'all can answer those questions.
This is a badge of ballots by election district.
Okay.
That's essentially one tray of ballots received by the post office.
Okay.
And that's, even if we've done this by election district, we still have a tray of ballots, and you have.
That's all fine, but I'm gonna state the same thing.
But to sort them, to somehow pull them apart from these badges and store them by city or by election district or whatever, we don't have the staff to do that.
You and I, I understand what you're saying, but.
Excuse me, can I interject for one second? I want a separate meeting. I'm just, you know, with you, Howard, but I think this is what has to be said, because you guys are gonna keep going on about this. But under Title 15, Section 5510, it's not an option to sort them alphabetically. By the code, you have to sort the absentee ballot by election district. So Title 15, 5510. So you don't have the authority to choose.
Yeah, further on, there's a thing that we can develop our own procedures.
Okay, but the normal protocol is to sort them by election district. You, as the commission, you have the right to do really whatever you want, but the code says the process that should, the recommended process and voted by the legislature, I guess Charles, you were part of that, is that they be selected by election district. What I'm concerned with, which I should be able to get access to, are the ballots that were contested in those results. Like, you know how many ballots where there were challenges or contested to, what the judge's ruling was on those ballots. Where's the list or number? There were no contested absentee ballots? Oh, out of 44,000, none, they were all perfect.
There was one where there was no ballot, but there was no ballot in the envelope that was returned.
Why?
And there were several where there were no signatures, but they were sent back to the voters to, we get between 3 and 4% of the ballots that come in by mail are not signed. We send them back to the voters.
How many of those were there?
3 to 4%.
And do you have a list of those? You should have a list of them. You didn't keep a list of tracking or anything?
No, they are sent back to the voters.
Yeah, but you didn't track that. Like, John Doe sent it in.
No.
The signature was not accepted.